being such a powerful magnet, we have to be very careful about what types of metal go near it. If you look in front of me, I have samples of three different types of metal. This is an aluminum plate, which is not ferromagnetic and is thus not attracted by the magnet. This is a copper bar, also not ferromagnetic. And then we have a pair of scissors that are made out of steel. And so you can see, even with this small workshop magnet, it's attracted quite strongly. An object like a pair of scissors, if brought into the MR suite, could become a deadly projectile. So that's an important safety issue with MR, and we do a lot of training in order to make sure that people are sensitized to the need to keep metal objects away from the system. Now, it's interesting to see how these non-ferromagnetic metals behave when brought in proximity to the MRI system. Demonstration that we're going to do, we'll use this piece of aluminum, which has a fairly large surface area, and it's, although it's not ferromagnetic, it's a conductive material. So if we're sitting out here outside of the magnetic field, if I let go of this, it's going to fall over just like that. And what we're going to see inside the magnetic field is the plate will resist changes in its orientation because these induce currents within the conductive material of the plate that essentially exert a magnetic force that prevents it from wanting to fall over. Because this aluminum plate is not ferromagnetic, we can safely bring it close to the bore of the magnet, and as you can see, it's not attracted, so it doesn't pose the type of danger that the scissors did in the previous demonstration. So we'll let go of the plate and we'll see that it falls over very slowly, almost like it's suspended in molasses. So I find this serves as a really good visual demonstration of just how powerful the magnetic field is, and this is what's required to create the polarization of the atomic nuclei in your body that we use to generate these images.